On the wedding night, Taliyah arose from bed and said to his wife, "Sister, get up. Let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and to grant us deliverance." Sarah got up and they started to pray and beg that deliverance might be theirs. They began with these words, "Blessed are you, O God of our fathers. Praise be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creation praise you forever. You made Adam and you gave him his wife Eve to be his help and support. And from these two, the human race descended. You said it is not good for the man to be alone. Let us make him a partner like himself. Now, Lord, you know that I take this wife of mine, not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Hold on your mercy on me and on her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age." They said together, "Amen, amen." The word of the Lord. The Lord is kind and merciful. Bless me. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Some Pharisees approached Jesus and tested him, saying, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any cause, whatever?" He said in reply, "Have you not read that from the beginning the Creator made them male and female? Said, 'For this reason, the man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh.' So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, man must not separate." The Gospel of the Lord. Celebrated countless baptisms. I have heard confessions of a lot of people and anointed, maybe sick people. But to preside at this celebration, this is a rare occasion. I can count on the fingers. years of my life, and the number of times I have recited at this celebration. So I was, I felt so privileged and happy that I was able to share with this couple, the family, this very special occasion in their life. Cesar, especially, is very familiar to me because we see each other almost every day, or at least every time I celebrate Mass. It's always there. I find this occasion very special because, as I've said, this seldom happens. Blessed and fortunate is the Pascal couple and the family that celebrates this type of occasion. For a couple to celebrate only wedding anniversary, first, they must be faithful to each other. Like these are the two things, important things, that a couple should have to reach this stage in their married life. I remember when, more than 20 years ago, when my father was lung cancer, and he was given a few months to live. I prayed fervently to God the following year, the year after he died, we were supposed to celebrate their golden anniversary. And as a priest, I was looking forward to that. In fact, I maybe prepared my homily for that occasion, and I received this already planning. The event, unfortunately, but that has other plans for our parents. That's why we should be greatly grateful to God for this occasion. We are so blessed as an Angela in having reached this moment in your life. I'm sure you can still recall that day when we vowed to love each other in sickness and in health, for each or poor, until death do we part. Those that vow could then be very true until this moment, and this moment proves that we can be faithful to the vows that we made. Nowadays, people put less importance, less value on words. We simply utter things without really reflecting on the value of the words, especially the promises of the gods that we make. And because of this social media and the other means of communication, we just say things or text things which we take on. 50 years ago, Cesar D'Angelo vowed, promised to love each other. That promise actually was tested several times in your married life. Perhaps there were times that you were ready to break the promise. Perhaps there were times that you had some regrets. But because of the vow, you persisted, especially when you as far as making a commitment, making a vow is concerned, I know how it is to commit myself to someone or to something. In my case, committing myself to my vocations at least, committing myself to God. It is only when we are able to commit ourselves to something that we find real meaning in life, that we find that there will be a meaning of happiness, the ability to commit. Sad is the person, or I pity the person, or that person who cannot make any serious commitment, whether to someone, to a family, to a cause, or to a vocation. I feel sorry for that person who has been successful, because it is only by committing ourselves to someone or to something, to a goal, to a vision, to values that we find meaning in life. I'm sure your children are more excited than you. Yeah, because as I said at the beginning, you were not there when they were married. Now it's an opportunity for us to witness that your parents profess their love for your son. You know, we all know Filipinos very much so expressive of our emotion. Kahit mahal na mahal na natin ang isang tao, lalo na tayong mga lalaki Filipino, hindi tayo masyado we're not so expressive. Para sa atin, to express one's emotion is a sign of weakness. Gusto natin pagbigyan ng pagkakitari tayo ng macho, patatak. Di malaking kahingan sa atin, mapipiliw na natin ang makita na titil pa o tumihiya. Siguro ngayon pa naman, hindi na dapat pagbaguhin na natin, especially in expressing, showing our love. Not only through words, but especially through actions. We should always be ready. We should always be spontaneous in showing that we love each other. Says Archangel, God has blessed you. God who sanctified your love for each other blessed you with this moment, because you have been faithful to him, because of the Christian life that you have lived, because of the love and service that you have shown to your children, to your family. God has blessed you. Blessed are those who walk on the path of the Lord, the Bible says, because they will be greatly blessed. The brothers and sisters, let us join our Lord God here and give you thanks to God and the rest of the family in thanking God for the blessings that they have received. Please stand. Cesar and Angela, on the anniversary of the celebration at which you join your lives in an unbreakable bond through the sacrament of matrimony, you now intend to renew before the Lord the promises you made to one another. Turn to the Lord in prayer that these vows and respected by divine grace. In silence, we pray for Cesar and Angela and your brothers as they prepare to renew their vows. Blessed are you, Lord, for by your goodness I took Angela as my wife. Angela is my beloved. Blessed are you, Lord, for by your goodness I took Cesar as my husband. Now, both of you, be after me. Blessed are you, Lord, for in the good and the bad times of my life, you have stood loving me by your side. Help us, we pray, to remain faithful in our love for one another, so that we may be true witnesses to the covenant you have made with humankind. May the Lord keep you safe all the days of your life. May He be your comfort in adversity and your support in prosperity. May He fill your home with His blessings through Christ our Lord. Sanctify, Lord, the love of your servants, Cesar and Angela, who once gave each other his wings as a sign of faithfulness, that they may always grow in the grace of the sacrament through Christ our Lord. Bless and sanctify the love of your servants, O Lord, that is free. Sign your faithfulness, remind them of their love for one another, and recall the grace of the sacrament. Cesar and Angela, Father, our Lord, faithful, requiring and rewarding the servants of your covenant, be pleased to fill with your blessings these your servants, Angela and Cesar, who celebrate the 50th anniversary of their parents. Renew the fidelity of your servants, Lord. Holy Father, who with your Son and Holy Spirit enjoy from eternity, perfect oneness of life and communion of love, grant that these your servants may always remember and faithfully keep the covenant of love they made in the sacrament. Renew the fidelity of your servants, Lord. Holy Father, who in your providence hold their own experiences of human life, so as to lead the faithful to share in the mystery of Christ, grant that these your servants, serenely accepting all good times of God, may strive to
marriage should be an example of Christian living, grant that all married couples may be witnesses in the world.
During my homily that there are two important things
that the couple must be blessed with to reach this moment in their lives, their lives. First, the gift of faithfulness, which we faithful to each other, kasi marami, kahit marami na hindi nakarating sa point nito kasi wala ko. And second, the blessing of long and healthy life. Merong pangatlo, the blessing of a good mind or a sound mind. Kasi pag may dimension lang na, how can you redo your vows kung hindi mo nakilala? Right? It just came to my mind because I remember this story about this. Two couples, magpakala sila, dalawang magkasama. They're already elderly couples. And they had dinner at the house of one of the couples. And after dinner, yung babae, yung dalawang babae, they went to the kitchen to wash the dishes. Yung dalawang lalaki, they say that they went to the living room para mag-inom-inom ng kape. Yung isang lalaki, the man said, you know what, that was a good dinner that we had. I remember that time when we had dinner at this restaurant. You know, I can't recall the name of that restaurant, I already forgot. Do you remember the name of that restaurant? He asked the other guy. And the other guy said, what's the name again of the flower that is red? And the other guy said, oh, Rose. And the man said, hey, Rose, calling his wife. Do you know the name of the restaurant where we ate last week? So this is usually what happens to those people who have reached a certain age of their life, they become forgetful. But don't you ever forget the vow that you made to each other. Answer God. Happy to hear and give choice because with you, because we've been faithful to God. Please stand. The Lord be with you. Cesar and Angela, please bow your head as a faithfulness blessing. May God, your powerful Father, grant you his joy. Amen. May the only begotten Son of God stand by you in compassion in good times and bad. May the Holy Spirit always pour forth his love in your hearts. And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our celebration is ended. Let us go in peace.